Hello students, in the previous class we have discussed how to derive the equation of motion by Dapital method. What are the equations of motion? V is equal to u plus ct, s is equal to ut plus half a t square, s is equal to v square is equal to u square plus 2a. Based on this equation of motion, even we have seen the special cases also. When the special cases, when the initial velocity is 0 and the acceleration is negative, that is retardation. In today's class, we are going to discuss the numericals on equations of motion. Without wasting the time, quickly let us start our first problem. So, what is the first problem? See, till now we have solved many problems. And I have told you, first and foremost thing we need to do when we are solving a problem is we need to write a given data. Let us see that. A car acquires a velocity of 72 km per hour. What they have given? They have given velocity. So velocity is how much? 72 km per hour. Next, what it is in 10 seconds. What is 10 seconds? Time is 10 seconds. So these all are given things. So given. Time is also 10 seconds. Starting from rest. Starting from rest means initial velocity is how much? Initial velocity is 0. Final velocity is moving. But we can see that this is in kilometer per hour. What we need to do when it is in kilometer per hour? We need to convert to meter per second. If we need to convert from meter per second, we need to multiply by 5 by 80 or 1000 by 3600. Both are correct. Now 80 ones are 84. So 5000 how much? 20 meter per second. This is the final velocity. It is moving. Now calculate the acceleration. So first I need to calculate what? We need to find out what you mean by acceleration. So what is the formula for the acceleration? What is the formula for the acceleration? Acceleration means it is final velocity minus initial velocity by time. You know that we have been derived even this. Out of this equation only we get that. What it is? Equation of motion, that is acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity by time. So what is the final velocity here? Final velocity is 20 meter per second minus what was our initial velocity? Initial velocity is 0. And what is the time? Time we have taken as 10 seconds. So what do you mean acceleration here? Acceleration is 20 by 10 seconds. This is meter per second. So if you cancel 1010, I get 2. That is 2 meter per second square. This is the acceleration. You must be very careful. So what is the unit of acceleration? It is meter per second square. If it is velocity, it is meter per second. So the first thing we have been found, that is acceleration is how much? 2 meter per second square. So what is the second one? Second one we have average velocity. Second one, we need to find average velocity. So what is the formula for average velocity? Formula for average velocity is initial velocity plus final velocity by time. Understand? Initial plus final by time taken, total time taken. So what is the initial velocity? Initial velocity was 0. Final velocity is how much? 20. What is the time? 10. Therefore, how much it is also? It is also velocity, right? It is 2 meter per second. How did I get 2 meter? See, because I have velocity is equal to 20 by 10. Cancels. So, I have what do you mean by 2 meter per second? What is the unit of velocity? Meter per second. So, what is the third one I need to find? Third one is the distance traveled. What I have to find? The distance traveled. So to find the distance traveled, I need to use the equations of motion. What it is? The equations. What are the equations of motion? Just I am writing here the equations of motion. V is equals to u plus at. S is equals to ut plus half at square. Then I have v square is equal to u square plus 2a. Yes. Right. See the first equation of motion.
Do we have a distance traveled? What do you mean by distance traveled? Distance traveled is yes. Do we have yes here? No. So we cannot take the first equation of motion. Understand? What is the second equation of motion? We have distance traveled. Yes. What it is? S is equals to ut plus half a t squared. Let me use the second equation of motion. That is, S is equals to ut plus half a t squared.
You know that one special case. What is the special case? When we have initial velocity to be zero, what happens to this equation? If the equation reduces to S is equals to half a t squared.
You know very well known. So S is equals to half. What is the acceleration I have got? Acceleration is also 2. What is time? Time is 10 seconds. That is t square. So I have S is equals to 2 cancel. What is 10 square? 10 square is 100. What is the unit of distance? Distance is usually measured in meter. Therefore, distance traveled is how much? 100 meter.
Very easy. See, why can't I take this equation?
I cannot take this equation. Let me try with this equation whether I get or not. See, we need to find distance traveled. Here I have a distance traveled. Right. So let me check whether I get or not. So I have v square is equals to u square plus 2ab. Yes. So what is the final velocity I have? Final velocity I have 10 meter per second. No? Final velocity is 20. 20 square is equals to. Then what I have? Initial velocity is 0 plus 2 into, what is that? Acceleration is 2. So we don't know this. Yes. Therefore 20 square is how much? 400 is equals to. So I have, this is 0. So 2 is a 4. Yes. And I want what distance traveled? S is equals to 400 by 4. That is, it is 100. That is, S is equals to how much? 100 meter. Even by using this equation of motion also, I am getting the same answer. Two particular problem we need to check by a given data. If you want to find this distance traveled, you can use any of the equations in this book. You get a correct answer. Understand? We need to find out by using a given data. Look at here. If I use even second equation of motion, I have got a correct answer. Even I have used the third equation of motion, even I got a correct answer. But why did I didn't use first equation of motion? In first equation of motion, there is no distance traveled. There is only final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration and time. Understand? This is how you need to think to do the problem and solve many. It's the level of your understanding. It's that once if you have understood the concept, it's very easy. So now we will go further. Now we have our second problem. Let us see what the second problem is. What it is, a body initially at rest. So whenever you see a problem, write a given data. So in given data, whenever you look into a body initially at rest, initially at rest means write off that initial velocity to be 0. Initially at rest. Travels a distance 100 meter distance. So what is the distance? S is equals to how much? 100 meter. In what? 5 seconds. Therefore, time is equals to what? Seconds. Right. With a constant of acceleration, calculate what we need to find. To find things are given that we need to find what is first one, acceleration. So we don't know what is the acceleration. What is the second one? The final velocity at the end of 5 seconds. The final velocity. You need to take final velocity is what? V. We don't know this. So let us start with a formula. What is the first one we need to find? See, we need to find the acceleration. So what is the formula of acceleration? You already know acceleration is equals to final minus initial by time. Final velocity minus initial velocity by time. But can I use this equation? This formula can I use? No. Why? Because final velocity itself is unknown. So you have to eliminate this formula. We cannot use this. What is the other? We have equations of motion. Let us take. See, look at here. I will write the equations of motion here. V is equals to u plus at is 2 ut plus half at square, then v square is equal to u square plus 2as.
Here, can I use first equation of motion? What I used to find first? Acceleration. Can I use this? Means even the initial final velocity given. Final velocity is unknown here. We cannot find if two unknown quantities are given in the same equation. So this equation also we cannot use. First equation of motion. Come back to second equation of motion. Distance s is now s. Initial velocity is now. Time is now. And even here we have time. The time is also now. But the only thing we doesn't know here is acceleration. So here we have to use second equation of motion. So from second equation of motion. So we need to think in this way how to find. So what is second equation of motion we have? S is equals to ut plus half at square. What is s? S is 100 meter. Equals to what is u into t. Initial velocity, since it is 0, I will not substitute anything there. Just I will take half. What is a? Acceleration. I does not know that itself. A into what is t? T is 5 seconds. So 5 square. Right. Now if 2 goes to the numerator, what happens? It is 2 into 100 is equals to 5 square is 25 into A. Correct. So 100 plus I have 200 is equals to what I have 25 A. So if I want acceleration, what it is? So acceleration is equals to 200 by how much? 25. So do the cancellations directly from 25 table you can take, or you can take even by 5 table. 25 table you can take 25 under 25 A is up. You know that. Otherwise, start from 5. 5 5s are 25, 5 4s are 20, then 5 1s are 5 8s are 40. So you have acceleration. So 8 meter per second square. This is your acceleration. Understand? First one we have found it. Did you understand why we need to take the second equation of motion? Because according to the given data, what are the given things we have? We can do by using, we can find acceleration only by second equation of motion. Now what I need to find? The final velocity at the end of 5 seconds. Here, time I have to take at the end of 5 seconds. So, come to the equation of motion. V is the final velocity. Can I take the first equation of motion? Thinking. So, if I want to take first equation, is initial velocity is now? Yes. Acceleration is now? Yes. Just show me how to note acceleration. Time is now? Yes. The results give time is 5 seconds. So, I can take the first equation of motion. So from first equation of motion. From first equation of motion I have V is equals to U plus UT. So V I don't know. So initial velocity is 0 plus acceleration is how much? 8 into time is 5. So I have velocity is equals to. So this 8 5 is how much? 40 meter per second is the argument of velocity. Look at here. Acceleration is meter per second square. Velocity is meter per second. So how did I get the unit of meter per second? See, for acceleration we have meter per second square into for a time I have second. Right? 1 second, 1 second cancels. Therefore I got meter per. Understand the second problem. See, by this way, according to the given data, whatever the thing you need to find, you need to choose the equation of motion. I hope you have understood the second problem completely. Now we will move on to third. We have our third problem. Let us see how it is. A car initially at rest. So what is the given? Initially at rest, whenever you see you have right, u is equals to 0. Initial velocity. Moving with a constant acceleration of 0.5 meter per second square. So they have given acceleration to be 0.5 meter per second square. And travels a distance of how much? 25 meters. So distance is given, s is equals to how much? 25 meter. What need to find?
The volume to find. So we need to find first one final velocity. So v is equal to first one and the time delta. So we also don't know this time.
Now, what is the formula I can do v2?
So what is the first one I need to find?
I need to find first one final velocity. Come here. Where is the final velocity? We have in equation 1. In equation 1, if I want to find final velocity, if initial velocity is now?
Yes.
Is acceleration is now?
Yes.
But what about time? Time itself I doesn't know. So we cannot use our first equation of motion. Let us move to second equation of motion. Second equation of motion, distance is now?
Yes.
Initial velocity?
Yes.
Time again here. We doesn't know time itself. So I can eliminate even second equation of motion. I cannot use second equation of motion also to find the final velocity. The last option we have what we mean by third equation of motion. What is third equation? V is final velocity. That is what we need to find. We know initial velocity?
Yes,
we know. We know acceleration?
Yes,
we know. We know distance? So I can use the third equation of motion. In the same way, you need to think over which equation we should use. Understand? So I will use from third equation of motion, from third equation of motion we have, third equation of motion we have v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Understand? So what is v? V does not is v square. U square is 0. I need not write that. It's okay. I have to remain here. You can use your special case. The initial velocity is 0, just you can take v square is equal to 2as. Even that is correct. So 2 into what is acceleration?
Acceleration is 0.5.
Right. What is the distance?
Distance is 25.
Can you see that? Then I have v square is equal to 0.5 into 2. How much is 0.5 into 2?
Is 1.
So 1, 0 square is 0, no doubt. So 1 into how much it is? 25. Therefore I have v square is equal to 25. Now what I should do? Mathematics. I have square towards my left RHS. If you send the square to your RHS, what happens? From LHS to RHS, it becomes square root. So we have v is equal to square root of 25. Is the 25 a perfect square?
Yes,
25 is a perfect square. So we know v is equal to how much?
5 meter per second.
This is the final velocity. Velocity SI is? See how easily we can do only by using this equation of motion. First, you need to think according to the given data what we need to find and which equation of motion we should use. Then, what is the next one? The time data. We need to find the time. Come here, let us start from first equation of motion now. We know final velocity?
Yes,
just now we have found final velocity. We know initial velocity?
Yes,
initial velocity is given. We know acceleration?
Yes,
we know acceleration also. We don't know time. See, out of time, all the v is known. So I can use first equation of motion to find the time. So from first equation of motion, so what I have, v is equal to u plus at. So what is the final velocity?
Phi is equal to 0 plus acceleration is how much?
0.5.
Yeah, we have 0.5 into 0 meter time.
So now, so we have time is equal to what happens?
5 by 0.5.
So now what I have to do? I have a decimal. So I will multiply by 10 to both numerator and denominator. So it becomes 5 times 50 by 0.5 into 10 gives me 5. So 5 ones are 5 times that. So I've got time is equal to how much?
10 seconds.
Look at here. Very easy. See, second you have tried only small. This S. You should not write SAC. That is wrong. This if you want to write only mention.
Yes.
So I hope you have understood this third problem. Next we are going to do that. Now we have our fourth problem. Let us see what it is. A body with an initial velocity of 18 km per hour. So what is it given? A body with an initial velocity. So u is equal to how much?
U it is 18 kilometer per hour. See, first, whenever you see this kilometer per hour, we need to convert to SI units. Start doing it. So, if you want to convert to meter per second, what you do? You will multiply by 5 by 18. So, 18 ones are. So, it is 5 meter per second. You have done your first one. Accelerate uniformly at the rate of 9 centimeter square. So, what is the acceleration given? Acceleration is 9 centimeter per second square. See, even this is not in the SI unit, but we will wait for some time. Then over a distance of 200 centimeters. So distance is equal to how much? 200 meter. Then what I need to calculate to find? I need to find acceleration itself. First one, acceleration in meter per second square. Acceleration in meter per second square. And I need to find the second one is its final velocity in meter per second. I need to find final velocity in meter per second. See here, what is that we need to find the formula? They have given acceleration in centimeter per second square. But I need to convert what? I need to find acceleration in meter per second square. So when they have given in centimeter per second square, how will you convert to meter per second square? See what it is, 1 meter is equal to how many centimeter? 100 centimeter. So always when you convert from centimeter to meter, you need to multiply, divide by 100. What it is, you need to divide by 100. When you divide 9 by 100, what happens? Decimal fraction. If you have two zeros, it shifts to two zeros that side. So 0.09. That is 0.09 meters per second square. Even you can do this division, simple division, you will get even 0.09 meter per second square. So this is the acceleration they was given in centimeter per second square. We have found out in now meter per second square. So what is the second one we need to find? Second one we need to find is final velocity meter per second. Use this equations of motion. Just I will write equations of motion now here. V is equal to u plus ab. This is equal to ut plus half a t square. V square is equal to u square plus 2as. So which equation I can use? Which is the final velocity? I have final velocity here. So I know initial velocity. Yes, initial velocity is now. Do I know acceleration? Yes, given I know acceleration. Do I know time? Time is being given? No, time is not given. Yes, I cannot use the first equation of motion. In the second equation of motion, there is no final velocity only. There is no final velocity only. So I cannot use that equation. Can I use third equation? Yes, we need to find final velocity. Initial velocity is given. Acceleration we have found it out. And distance also is given. This is how you need to find which equation of motion we need to use. So from third equation of motion, I know that v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So now what is v square is equal to? U square is how much? I have got 5 meter per second. So 5 square direct I will write 25 plus 2 into what is acceleration I got? Acceleration in meter per second square is 0.09. So what is the distance? Distance is 200. Understand? Now I have v square is equal to 25 plus. I need to multiply this. First I multiply 200 2s are 400. 400 into 0.09 meters. 0.09 4s are 36. 1, 2, 3. You know this multiplication also 630. So after how many decimal the point? 32. So this is if zero towards the left side also there is no meaning. So I have got this complete thing to be how much? 36. So if I add v square is equal to 36 plus 25 is how much? 30 into 50. So I have got 61. So what I need to find? I need to shift this square to square root of LHS to RHS, so it becomes 61. Is 61 a perfect square? No. If it was a perfect square like the last problem, we can easily write. Now what it is? We need to take the help of synthetic division. See, your physics will bring you till here, the knowledge of physics. But to continue further, mathematics is a very important tool. So I tell you, if you want to learn physics well, you should know the mathematics, because physics is helping you in all these equations. But when you come here, you won't get a mark when you leave it here, because you need to continue the problem. To continue the problem, what is needed? You need the help of mathematics. So I need to take the help of synthetic division. So you already know this, right? Now which number I can choose? I need to choose before 61, which is a perfect square? 7. So 7 is how much? It is 49. So if it is 49, how much? 11 plus 1? 12. Right. So 0, you get it. So I need to add one more 7 here. If I add one more 7 for this, it becomes 14. So what number? Point is here. The part number, if I have, I will get less than this, I need to check. So let me check. 148 into 8. 8 4 7. 32 plus 6, 38. 8 1 is 8 plus 3, 11. So I can take that. 1184. So how much? 1184, if you take, you get just 16. So it's okay. We need not continue. So it is 8 and you need to do the synthetic division. So enough, one decimal point is enough. So what is the final velocity required? Final velocity is 7.8 meter per second. This is the final velocity. See, with the help of mathematics only, I have done this. So please learn. I hope you know this synthetic division in your grade 8 of mathematics. Now, after understanding this problem of 4, we are going to the now we have our fifth problem. What it is? A ball is initially moving with the velocity of 0.5 meter per second square. So first let us write the given data. What is the given? Initially moving with the velocity. So initial velocity is how much? 0.5 meter per second square. No, initially moving with the velocity. Sorry, velocity of it may be 0.5 meter per second. Right. Its velocity increases at a rate of 0.05 meter per second square. So acceleration is on. Look at here. Velocity is decreasing. Decreasing means what acceleration will be? Acceleration will be retardation. So we need to take minus 0.05 meter per second square. In vector unit, it is retardation. So when the retardation happens, what will be your final velocity? Final velocity will be zero. It comes to this, right? So these are the given data. So what we need to find? How much time it will take to stop? So first one we need to find, first of all, what is time? And what is the second one we need to find? How much distance will the ball travel? So this is equal to question one. So which formula I need to use now? So first I need to find the time, however. So let me take the equations of motion. So I have to use u plus at. Let me square. Then I have v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Now, see the first equation of motion, I need to find time. Is there time? Yes, we can find time. But we know final velocity. Yes, final velocity is how much? Zero. We know that. Initial velocity? Yes, initial velocity is 0.5 meter per second. Acceleration we know? Yes, it is minus 0.05 meter per second square. So we can go with the first equation of motion. From first equation of motion. From first equation of motion, we have v is equal to 2 plus at. So in final velocity is 0, initial velocity is how much? 0.5 So here plus and minus becomes minus because it is in the negative x direction. It is 0.05 meter into t. I need to find t. So now if I bring complete this to RHS, what happens? So that becomes plus 0.05 t is equals to 0.5. I hope you have understood this math. Entire this curve I have walked from RHS to LHS. So if I want to find time now, it is 0.5 by 0.05. Now how will you do this? Both decimal numbers. See, when it is a decimal number, always you should see the numerator. In a numerator, after how many points there is? After a point, how many numbers? One number. So I will multiply by 10 on the both. So this becomes 5 by this becomes 0.5. Now again there is a decimal in the denominator. So take again multiply 10 and 10. So it becomes 10 by 50 by 5. So 5 and 5 and 10 is 5. So I have time is equal to how much? 10 seconds. So I have time is equal to 10 seconds. Understand? This is the time. Now what I need to find the second one? Second one I need to find the distance traveled. Second one. So you can use any of the equations. When it is distance traveled, any of the equations you can use. But to do that calculation very easily, you can take third equation. In the second equation of motion, a big cancellation and it takes more time. So use third equation of motion. So u square is equal to u square plus 2as. So we need to find v square is how much? 0 initial. Initial velocity is how much? 0.5 the whole square plus 2 into what is the acceleration I have got? Acceleration is minus 0.09 into how much? It is s. We need the distance. So what happens now? 0.5 square is how much? It's 1 here. 0.5 into 0.5. 8. 5 is 25, right? 2. So we have 0, 0, 5, 2, 0 after 2 points. So it is how much? 0.25 plus, we need to consider this 0.05 into 2 is how much? 0.05 into 2. 10, 0. Right, after 2 decimal it will be, it becomes 0.10. Yes, we have this, yes, for this. Next, what happens when this becomes, we have 0 here, bring that, we have this, so it will be minus, because plus and minus is minus, then bring that this side, so it becomes 0.1, this is equal to 0.2. So if you want distance to be 0.25 by 0.1. Now what you need to do? You need to multiply by hundreds. Why after decimal there are two numbers. So multiply by 100. So I have 25 by. So 0.1 into 100, how much it becomes? It becomes 10. So 25 by 10 I have. So 25 means 25 by 10 I can divide here for this speaking terms. 10 to 25 is the remainder. Keep a point at 0, 10 by 10. So you can even cancel like 5 to 5 by 10 again, you have to take a division, however. So there are instances equals to how much I have 2.5 meter. Look at the calculations. Here you know physics, but a mathematics plays a very important role. The knowledge of decimal fractions is needed here. If you forget the decimal fraction, which to act for, and always when you are doing a decimal fraction, you should give importance to numerator. In a numerator, after a point, if it is single digit multiply with 10, double digit multiply with 100, you should not consider the denominator. This is the basic of mathematics. So in this, we have got time to be 10 seconds, distance to be 2.5 meter. Now we will go for our last problem for the session. It is a sixth problem. It it's a bit a big problem, but it is not at all a tough problem. If you know a lot of the physics and mathematics to do to solve this problem, is very easy. Let us quickly go to the problem. What we have? First, let us write a given. What are the given data? So, a body moving with a uniform acceleration travels 84 meters in the first 6 seconds. So, let us take distance to be S1. What is the first distance? I have 84 meter in first 6 seconds. So, T1 is how much? I have taken 6 seconds. And 180 meter in the next 5 seconds. So, for S2, I need to consider 84 plus how much? Next it is traveling 180. So, how much is 180 and 84? 180, 84, 264 meter. 264 meter. It is traveling in time how much? T2. T2 is equal to next 5 seconds. So, 6 seconds plus 5 seconds gives me 11 seconds. Understand? It gives me 11 seconds. Now, what I need to find? Find initial velocity and the acceleration of the body. What is to be found? To find first one, initial velocity, we don't know. What is the second one we need to find? We need to find the acceleration of the body. So, how to find out this? So, formula. I will consider from second equation of motion. From a second equation of motion, take first one. For how much? For first 6 seconds. For first 6 seconds, what is the expression I have? S is equals to ut plus half at square. This is the equation I have. What is S1 if you consider? Otherwise, make it S1, T1. So, S1 is how much? 84 meter is equals to what is U? U we have? No, we don't know U. U into time is how much? 6 plus half into. What is the acceleration is given? No, we don't have acceleration also. So, T1 square, that is 6 square is how much? 36. I am writing it directly. T1 square 36. Now, if you cancel anything, this 2 ones are 2 18s are 36. So, I have 84 is equals to 6U. U into 6 is 6U plus what I have? 18A. Did you understand this equation? Now, I will take this entire thing this side. So, if we shift that 6U plus 18A is equals to how much? 84. Now, I can make still this equation to be a lower equation. Divide by 6 throughout the equation. If you divide by 6 throughout the equation, what do you get? So, like she divided by 6, divided by 6, divided by 6. I have, when you get an equation, U plus 6 ones are 6 threes are 18. So, I have got 3A is equals to, so if 6 goes here, how much? 6 ones are 6, 6 fours are, that is 14. Consider this to be equation 1. Understand? This to be equation 1. Next, I have, marking you. Next, second one, I have this for how much seconds? For next, it's 11 seconds. For next, 11 seconds. If I consider, S2 is equals to U into plus half AT square. So, what is S2 I have got? S2 I have got as 264. Is equals to what is U? U you doesn't know. So U into T2 is how much? 11 plus half into. You doesn't know what is mean by acceleration A. What is T square? T is how much? 11 7 square I will take it directly as 121.
Understand? Now what is 18
can be cancelled? 2. No, this also you cannot cancel. So what you have? You have 264 is equals to 11 u plus you have 121 a by 2. Understand? Now shift that equation to this side. So we have 11 u plus 121 a by 2 is equals to 264. Now I can divide this equation to 11. Divide by 11 throughout the equation. Divide by 11, what I get? 11 u by 11. I will show you here. Let's see here. So 121 a by 2 was already there, but still I am dividing it by 11. By 11 is equals to 264 by 11. So now cancel. 11 and 11 is cancelled. So you got u plus. So 11 ones are 11, 11 is up. So I have got this 11 by 2 a. This 2, nothing happens to this 2. It remains the same. Observe here. Is equals to. Now 264 go by 11. We will try. 11 ones are 11 twos are how much? 22. So how much is the remainder? 4. So 11 fours are 44. So we have got 24. Consider this to be equation 2. Understand? This to be equation 1 and this to be equation 2. Now in the much math. Every mathematics has been involved here. Now look at here. We need to equate equation 1 and 2. You might have done this. Equating equation 1 and 2. What is the first equation I have? U plus 3a is equal to how much? 14. Right? What is the second equation I have? Second equation I have u plus 11 by 2a is equals to how much? 24. Right? Now what I need to do? I need to change the signs. Here we have plus and plus, minus. If I change the signs, u gets cancelled. Right? Then what I will left? See, minus sign will be there for 11 by 2a and plus sign for 3a is equals to. So here I have minus 24 and plus 14. What happens? Greater sign. So I get minus 10 I will get. So can I equate this? Yes, I will start doing this. Take an LCM here. If I take an LCM, what I get? I get 2 as an LCM. So 2 ones are therefore minus 11a. Understand? So what 2s are? So 3 2s are how much? I have got 6a is equal to minus 10. Understand? Now send 2 to that side. So I have got 11a plus 6a is equal to minus is minus 20. If 10 goes there. Now minus 11a plus 6a, how much? 11, 6 go means 5. So minus 5a is equal to minus 20. Cancel minus and minus. Now I have a is equal to 20 by 5. 5 ones are, 5 ones are. So acceleration I got 4 meter per second square. This is the acceleration. We have got the acceleration now. Can I find initial velocity? Yes. Use this acceleration in any one equation. Whether equation or 1 or 2. Now I will do that. Yes. Equating. Substituting. You have to take substitute acceleration is equal to 4 meter per second square in equation 1. So what is the equation 1 I have? U plus 3a is equal to how much? 14. So u plus, what is the value you have? 3 into 4 is equal to how much? 14. So u plus 3 4 is 12 is equals to 14. So u, if you want, send 12 that side. So it becomes 14 minus 12. 14 minus 12 is how much? So we have 2. Initial velocity is 2 meter per second. Did you understand? A very huge problem. But if you understand and know the mathematics very beautifully, anything can be solved. Please keep solving. In your exercise, you have many problems to solve, and an application type of problems also. Start doing. Just don't copy from somewhere like an internet, and without solving this, don't write. Everywhere you need to solve this. Now just check your textbook. They have not solved this mathematics for you. Directly they have given the answers 4 meter per second square, 2 meter per. If you just copy that, from where you will learn? You won't learn, and you will be troubling your examination. So please go with that. I hope you have understood today's problem session. From the next class, we are going to the new chapter, that is laws of motion. Until then, take care.